Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're gonna see how to create this really cool Xerox photocopy effects, as you can see in here, using Adobe Photoshop. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, so let's go and open Photoshop, and then I will go and open the image I will be using. Alright, now this is a very simple effect to do, but it looks really cool and it got very popular. So with that being said, this effect actually works depending on the resolution of your image. So make sure that you have a good quality image, and also if you don't, just keep playing with the numbers of the filters and you will achieve basically the same thing. Another thing that I want to mention is make sure that you have the foreground and the background color set to the default. For example, if you don't have it set to the default, you can just press D on your keyboard and it will change it to the default color. Because most of the filters from the filter gallery are associated with the colors that you have in here. All right. So yeah, the first thing that I want to do is actually to convert this to smart object, and let's rename it to image. And then I will go to filter and we'll choose filter gallery. Let me press control default and make everything back to the default. All right. Now the first filter that I want to add is in the sketch folder. So open it and choose halftone pattern. Alright, now, as I said, you need to experiment with this. I mean, it's good that we have a preview in here, you can see exactly what you are doing. For example, for me, I will go for the size to around 5, because I don't want it to be that big. But for the contrast, I will go a little bit higher, maybe around 30. And yeah, make sure that the pattern type set to dot. Unless you want something different, you can go ahead and try it. For me, I will keep it to dot. All right, next, I will one click on this plus icon to add another filter. And as you can see, when I did that, it actually creates a copy of this. But it's okay, we can just go and, for example, the second filter I want to add is reticulation. So I will one click on it, and this will change it to the filter that I want. All right, again, can experiment with this. For me, I would change the density to around 21, and I would put down the foreground level to like 12, and for the background level I will keep it 5. All right, I will do the same. I will add another filter, and this time I will go to the artistic folder and I will choose dry brush. As you can see, our effects start to take shape. Now I will change the brush size to like 6. And maybe I would keep the brush details set to 8 and the texture set to 1. And again, make sure to experiment with this. Those numbers, it doesn't mean anything. You can just go ahead and look at your image and apply whatever you want. For this, I think it looks really cool. I'm happy with the result, so I will keep it like this and I will press OK. Alright, so basically this is our effects. Now I'm just gonna add maybe a gradient map. So I will go and choose gradient map. And then I will open the gradient, and in the black stop, I will double click on it. And then I will change it to maybe bluish color. Yeah, maybe I will keep it like this for now, and I will press OK. And then I will go to the light stop or the white, and I will select it and I will open the colors. And for this one, let's go for red. Actually, I think it looks really cool, maybe a little bit brighter or softer. Yeah, I think I will keep it like this, but I will go back to the blue and I will make it a little bit desaturated. Yeah, something like that. I think it looks really nice. And I'm not happy with the red, so I will go back and try to fix it. Yeah, I will keep it like this and I will press OK. Alright, now I'm gonna put down the fill a little bit to see where I want actually the color to be. Yeah, something like this for me. I think it looks really cool. But again, it's up to you. You can go ahead and add more if you want or create more gradient. But for me, I will stick with this. And then I will go and open one of the textures. I have in here two of them. I will make sure to put them down in the link from the description below, so you can download them if you want to follow along. Alright, so I will open the first texture directly to the image and rotate it. And I will make it bigger to fit, just like this. And then I will change the blending mode of this to screen. Let's see before and after. I think it looks really cool. Now we'll go back and open this one. And again, rotate it. Make it bigger to fit. Alright. And this one I will change it to either screen or lighten. Yeah, let's keep it screen, but I will put down the opacity a little bit, maybe 40%. And now let's go and check the before and after. So this is before and this is after. Alright, so I hope that you enjoy and you like this quick tutorial and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment any new words for more to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.